Welcome to Odyssey of the Dragonlords. You are all in the land of Thylea. For many ages, Thylea was a wilderness of centaurs, satyrs, cyclopes, and other creatures who worshipped their native gods, the Titans. Mortals who came to Thylea lived in small defenseless tribes until the arrival of the Dragonlords. The Dragonlords were an order of heroic dragon-riding mortals who came to Thylea 5 centuries ago. They initiated the first war against the Titans and defeated their armies. Most of the Dragonlords and their dragons were killed during this conflict. When all seemed lost, the mortals of Thylea were saved by the sudden appearance of the 5 gods who walked the land in mortal guise. They forced the Titans into a temporary truce called the Oath of Peace. The Oath of Peace has prevented open warfare with the Titans for 500 years, but now the truce is ending. The power of the 5 gods wanes, and the Titans prepare to wage war upon the mortals once again. You were all chosen by the Oracle to confront the ancient Titans and end the conflict once and for all. This requires you to fulfill the Oracle's prophecy and rebuild the ancient order of the Dragon Lords. Sidon, the ancient Titan who once ruled over Thylea long before the arrival of mortals, seeks to dominate the land once again and to be worshipped by all mortals. Lutheria, the mistress of death, is another ancient Titan. She is the sister wife of Sidon. She has dominion over the underworld, and she seeks to corrupt mortals and capture their souls for her own amusement. So yeah, that's it in a nutshell. Any questions?
Can I go get a beer?
Yes.
Go get the beer. Run.
You can go get a beer. Oh, I see. So, you all had some reason to visit with the Oracle. Versi was her name. She is a water nymph. And lo and behold, she was already being tortured by some creatures when you came upon her temple. Solano Deo, who is running a little late today, knew of the temple and actually had come from the temple when he met with you all at the Sour Vintage Tavern. You went with him to defeat a great boar that the Titans had sent to torture and ravage the lands of the Heartlands. Once you all defeated the boar, it was a sure thing that surely you were the Oracle's heroes. You then went to the Oracle's temple to find that she had been being tortured. You defeated the enemies, and she sat and gave you the prophecy that you are the ones to stop the destruction of all of the creatures of Thylea from the Titans and their wrath when the Oath of Peace ends. However, you must complete 3 great labors, which you had done. While you were completing those labors, Mike's character, a satyr from the old woods, had felt a calling as well and went to the temple of the Oracle. There, she told him some information, and he... do I wave? and he began his quest to figure out his personal quest as well as to find the heroes of the prophecy. Are you okay?
Do you hear the conversation out there?
Uh-huh. That's why I was rubbing your shoulders.
Yeah,
you
awesome.
No.
Glad that's on stream.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's... It's a bourbon night for Jocelyn, I guess. So yes, as you were completing the 3 great labors, Mike's character, the satyr, was in the old woods. And, what is that?
I have no idea.
Try to pronounce it.
I don't know.
Inspiration if you pronounce Cheers. It.
Why in Stefan error?
Inspiration!
No, but it's just like it's just a spell, but you can't say it or you'll blow it up.
Vine and Stuffener.
So
hey, something I won't use.
This satyr in the woods had finally found one of his quests in the domain of Demetria. However, when he arrived, there were slaughtered goatlings and a very dead Demetria, along with a very dead Akanthi. So the information he was seeking appeared to be lost, if not for some of the fey creatures that were around knew of a magical source that held information, another route by which he could obtain and continue his quest. Meanwhile, the rest of the party is in Astoria, and they relight the forge, the Mithril Forge, where Vulcan is currently working on wonderful weapons for them. And they went to the Mossy Temple and defeated Demetria and freed the young children of Astoria that had been under her spell, so to speak. And lastly, they went to the necropolis at Telemach, where they met the first Dragon Lord. And Solano Deo, in particular, was given some memories back to him, realizing that perhaps there was a transformation 500 years ago, and that his original form was that of a Dragon Lord named Jacena Ventrac. And with that change, he has developed and changed a bit, wanting to reignite the Dragon Lords and relive essentially what Jacena was trying to do, and that is to bring balance to the forces of the settlers against the Titans. After that, you all were you got really drunk and lost lots of time in Astoria and lost the princess Honora. You ran around with penis statues and oil and lightning bolts on your face and little small people running out of trunks and you calling them your good luck charm and whatnot. And then eventually you found the princess. Ashaya found the princess.
I don't think we actually lost the princess. Just gonna say that. Yeah. I think we were just playing an extended hide and go seek.
There you go.
So,
we were playing the hangover and we forgot who we were.
You started to make your way, with three dragons flying in the sky. They landed down and told you that the king of Mytros, King Acastus, had called upon your services, and you were to make your way to Mytros to continue your great labors. Meanwhile, throughout all of this, the person that has been by your side each and every way has been a young bard by the name of Kyrah. She met you at the Sour Vintage Tavern. She told you that she was working for the Oracle, Versi. And although Kyrah shared the name of the goddess of music, she denied this up and down until recently she admitted She knew that she fooled you all for so long, but she admitted that she was indeed the goddess of music because she offered up her services to stop the storm that the Lord of Storms, Sidon, had been using to torture the citizens of Mytros. So you've been in Mytros. You found you retrieved a boreal harp with the help of Ashaya and Ashaya's imp Lucas. You were able to prevent the harp from being damaged and use the harp to stop the storms using the spell Control Weather. So the storms in Mytros were stopped. In the middle of all that, you had to kill all of the priests at the cult of Lutheria and rescued about a dozen children in the basement that were to take up the sacrifices of the cult of Lutheria. And then you made your way towards town, like out of town. I think you were heading, because King Acostas gave you the map to the Ultros, the legendary ship that you'd heard so much about from several different sources. And it is across the land of Thylia, but on your way out of Mytros, you saw a chained and shackled Minotaur. And you tried to free him. You got into a battle with some thugs and a gladiator in the middle of a busy marketplace. You were actually in a side kind of building, but it was midday. And a battle erupted. You managed to unlock the cage that this Minotaur was in, and he bolted out into the street. We ended last session in the middle of that battle. Any questions? This is all catch up. I guess we could start without Solano Day. Let me just check, make sure I don't have any messages from him.
Yeah, I hear anything from
him. He said his class is from 4:30 to 5:30, and that's Central Time, so that's 6:30. So, yeah.
He'll pop up, maybe.
He'll pop up soon. But rather than continuing the battle as it was, we're going to zoom out a little bit. So, I'm going to bring everyone to this Mytros street scene and describe a little bit about what's going on here. So you had been in a type of a warehouse or a barn kind of building where they were keeping this Minotaur, and there was guards all around. You tried to be sneaky about it. You were not sneaky enough. Battle erupted. I believe Zark cast his like dragon breath thing that scared the living daylights out of most of them. So most of them began to flee. You freed the Minotaur that was locked up. He just took off into the streets. And what happens is essentially that some of them are kind of on guard and like sparring with you. Most of them leave, and you become very aware that there's commotion in the streets. And some of the thugs kind of back off into the side of the building as they seem to be aware of the situation in the streets. And you guys, it's up to you if you come out into the street, but you hear a voice that sounds like your friend, Commander Gaius, say, "You folks come out right now."
See that side on general?
He's the douchebag.
It's like you guys.
He is so the much. Commander of the Order of Sidon, and yes, he is in Mytros. You actually also hear King Acostas holler out to you. He says, "Enough now, boys. Put down your weapons. This is my city. And as you peer out, you see many, many Order of Sidon soldiers, and you see that Minotaur that you released is held by two soldiers in the street. There are several commoners around watching, and there's this kind of standoff energy, like a negotiation.
No, we're bad at that. We're bad at it. I got loading in for some reason.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to figure out when I was playing with the game, is why it wasn't
just stuck on the loading.
Yeah, I was stuck there too. I just logged out and logged back in.
Oh, that's how you did it.
Well, I'm still loading back in.
Try that.
Yeah, I don't know if I have too many assets or what.
Yeah, it doesn't seem to be loading for me.
Maybe somehow break it.
I'm stuck at 89%.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, that's what I was, even when I was by myself, there's all kinds of issues like that.
Did the update screw you over again?
Maybe. But that's actually why I updated, because things were so slow. I wonder if I'd accidentally imported like a whole game or something. I'll try to speed things up here, but I don't know.
It's not working. Is it just this map? No, wait. There we go.
Yeah, I wonder. I'm up.
Yeah, you can just describe it. It doesn't matter.
Okay.
I can see now. So.
Oh, that's good.
Try clicking the Mytros Street 2 up at the top. That's what loaded it for me.
Stuck at loading 89%.
Huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, I figured something was broken today because it was acting pretty messed up.
Is it just that map?
No, it was my whole game. I even removed some things and tried to clean it up, and apparently it's not working. Let's get rid of... Let's see. This all looks like stuff I made.
Yep, it went 100%. See, nothing but gray.
Yeah, so then click the Mytros Street 2. It should show that. At the top left.
Yeah, I'm clicking it. It says you cannot switch scenes until resources finish loading your VM.
Right. It said that to me, and then it loaded it.
Wait, what was the error? You cannot switch scenes until what?
Until resources finish loading. Okay, there we go. Finally.
Yep.
Okay. That took so much. There's not really anywhere to escape to.
Mike, are you on here?
I just have to... I got to the select token spot again.
Okay, yeah, you probably... See, have a, he doesn't have a token on here, right?
I could throw him on, just for the sake of watching.
Yeah, you might want to. Because he'll be black.
Yeah.
I see black.
You'll see a black screen.
Ooh.
All right. Sounds like we're rolling.
All right, so... I don't know where my music went either, but that's fine. So yes, there is commotion in the streets as King Acosta says, "Come on out now, weapons down."
I have a feeling they know who's in there, but it's like,
yeah, I'm not gonna necessarily put my weapons down. Like, I'll sheathe them and walk out, but I'm not just gonna like lay them on the floor.
Okay.
I'm just gonna look and see if there's any way any other out of here, in case I have to escape.
Yeah, I mean, you're in a sort of a barn building. There are stalls for horses, except there are minotaurs shackled in those stall kind of cages. And, I mean, perceivably, you'd be able to possibly break, you know, the stone walls, but it looks pretty sturdy.
Okay.
I mean, these are minotaurs that they're shackling up.
Do the people outside look hostile or just...
Most of them look like soldiers that are very statuesque in the sense that they're not moving. The two that are holding down the minotaur in the middle of the street look like they're, you know, bracing and ready for anything. They have their weapons... Well, all of them have their weapons drawn and they're waiting for orders.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm going to walk out and be like, that minotaur right there beat me. He deserves his freedom. Or she, I'm not sure.
Minotaur beat you?
In the ring. You remember watching my ass get kicked?
Ah, yes. The ritual sacrifice after the death of a Mytrosian soldier.
Sacrifice or fight? Because we fought, I got rocked, and then the Minotaur should go free, the other one, and I'm not taking his place, or her.
So and
I don't know if this is a female or male.
Acostas looks at you and kind of says, "Look around, boy," and you see several minotaurs chained up. He says, "You're in the minotaur market. This is what we do here. I know you're not from around here, but if you're not careful, you could be chained up like the rest of them. Do you dare sacrifice your freedom to help this poor beast?"
Potentially. What do I gotta do?
What do you have to do? You heroes think that you can just bulldoze your way in here? Think that you can just change our customs? Think you could just buy your way out of this? Ah.
I mean, I'm not talking about buying my way out of it, but we definitely stopped Sidon from, like, destroying this whole place, so hopefully that should give a little weight here, because, yeah, that wasn't your thoughts.
You're right. Do you hear that, citizens? These are the heroes that stopped the wrath of Sidon's hurricane. It's true. It does hold a little weight. And that weight may just be walking out of here without having shackles around your ankles.
With this minotaur.
You could purchase him.
How much?
How much?
Well, technically, it's a purchase of the agreement, since we don't actually deal in slavery.
So you definitely deal in slavery, but...
We deal in contracts. We are a civilized folk.
Seems like it.
A contract for this creature here. He is a prized one. Strong, healthy. For you heroes, 2,000 drachma.
You're a piece of shit.
So no deal?
How much was it?
2,000 drachma.
We have 2,000.
No. I don't. I'm nowhere near close to that.
I forgot where I put my money.
It's under inventory.
Inventory.
Solano Deo has about 200 drachma.
Yeah.
You son of a bitch. You're just going to make me spend all my gold.
How about 200 drachma?
You insult me, hero.
210.
Perhaps the Minotaurs aren't able to do math like us civilized folks. But that is an insult. That is not even a negotiation.
No, an insult is enslaving Minotaurs to fight to the death. That's an insult.
We have been engaged in this tradition for centuries. Who are you to come into our glorious city, the best city in all of Thylea, and challenge our traditions?
It wasn't the best city about 10 minutes ago when Sidon was wreaking havoc and throwing lightning bolts.
You mean demanding respect that he deserves?
Funny way to demand respect.
It is, but I do not question the Titans.
Why didn't you respect him then?
Oh, please. Of course. I made the sacrifices that I could. I encouraged the citizens to make the sacrifices.
So you wanted
and
to
yet die? It didn't happen.
No. Some believe that his wrath was caused by the arrival of the heroes themselves, he says. And you hear some mumbling from the crowd.
So, you wanted 2,000, about 1,500.
What's that?
What about, how low are you willing to go with the price?
Well, honestly, he is not my Minotaur to sell, but that is the going rate.
What about 1,500?
Well, you would have to talk to the gentleman who owns his contract. And you see this guy who's a little beat up. He's actually pretty scared towards Zark over there. I believe you cast some sort of dragon roar that frightened him a bit.
Yeah, he can't walk towards me at all. So
yeah, maybe I can walk towards him though, and just like use you as the threat, basically make it. So it's like the gold can be very low when I buy him.
Okay, Saren, roll persuasion with advantage.
I'd like to give him like a stern look and try and intimidate him.
He already has advantage.
Okay, yeah, it's a plus two. Wait, can I push shift or alt?
Alt.
Alt for advantage.
Yeah, it's been 2 weeks.
Or just roll it again and oh, there you go. Okay. So, yep, you're fine.
I can't see.
Yep.
Oh, right. It's invisible. Damn.
It's invisible. So he looks over to this man who owns him, and you see him kind of like hesitate and just look straight at Acostas, not at either of you, and sort of nods his head. And Acostas says, "See? Business like respectable folk." He agrees to 1,500 drachma.
Okay. Pray that we don't meet again. Great. I like him like to the shopkeeper, basically. And I after that pay him 1,500.
All right. The soldiers push this Minotaur towards you. And he comes to you and kind of whispers under his breath, and he says, "We need to get out of here."
No shit. No shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was just.
And Acosta says, "This is the Minotaur market. This is how we do business. You will respect our traditions, or you will face trial. I will let this incident go today. But please, tread carefully in Mytros."
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll be back.
Yeah, we'll be back one day.
And you will bow before me.
Nah.
A Minotaur, you will bow before me.
You're saying that to the Minotaur?
No, the Costas.
It was like I'm going to be the best knight there ever was.
The best there ever was.
I do hope your journey to the Ultros goes well.
And I hope that you stop enslaving people.
People. People. He turns to Saren and says, handle your beasts.
You handle yours. You can't seem to control them very well. Later. And it's like walks away.
Okay. So the soldiers watch you all. I'll assume Solano Deo joins you.
Real quick, what's the Minotaur's name?
Bullbug.
Was that really his name, or did you roll it?
No, it's Bullbug. That's his name. He is an NPC in this campaign.
Okay, it's like you roll names so much.
Yeah.
So it's like,
how else are you gonna name shit?
Bullbug.
His first kid, he's gonna roll the name for.
Bullbug.
That's not the barely, like, you see a Minotaur. So what's his name? Bullbug.
Bullbug. Got it. Alright, Bullbug. We need to get out of here.
Okay, do I go with you?
Yes.
If you want to live, just follow us.
Saren owns your contract, so technically he owns you, which I do not agree with. So we're going to have to tear that thing up. But I would like you to, like, accompany us.
Tearing it up, no, you need to write a contract freeing me. And so you guys have this conversation as you start to head out of the city of Mytros.
This world is so weird.
Is everyone well rested?
I kind of got beat up, so no.
No.
Oh,
no,
not,
we
not super
well
rested, but you leave. Oh, yeah, Saren, you're hurt. Okay. Let me just check my guide here. Let's see. Okay. So, you start to make your way out of... Okay, so Bullbug joins your crew. You make your way out of the city of Mytros.
Gotta catch them all.
And is any other NPCs with you? Is Lorius with you?
I think we left him there.
So, Kyrah and Lorius were with us, right?
Yeah.
At some point in time.
Yeah, she knows where to find us. It's like we're literally a signal. We're easy to find.
When we went into the temple, the cult temple, she wouldn't come in. She stayed outside.
Okay.
So she's around.
So I'll just leave this map up for a second as we do some just description and stuff. So
likely not happy about that.
About what?
Kyrah being around.
Oh. Kyrah is with you and she loves you.
Kyrah is obviously the bad guy. The big bad evil person in this freaking campaign.
So as you travel and you start to get out of the city gates, you are heading... let me actually bring you into the landing page since that has a map. So you're leaving Mytros kind of on the outside here, which means you have to go into the old woods towards the Mossy Temple. And the deadfalls are way over here. So... you could stop at the Sour Vintage. You could just camp overnight near the Mossy Temple or in the Old Woods somewhere. However, as soon as you start to make your way, I'll use this little blue token for the party. As you start to make your way out of town, Lorius keeps up with you and he says, wow, I've never heard someone talk to a king that way. That was scary and brave and maybe stupid. I don't know how you do that.
He's not a real king. King rules for all of his people, not just some of them.
Oh, well, there's so many different kinds in Mytros, but okay, well, where are we going? I'm a little nervous about the Dead Falls.
Why would you be nervous with a name like that? It seems quite ominous. I mean, safe.
Oh, safe. Dead Falls. Okay. If we're going to the Old Woods, I mean, that's kind of my territory. I could kind of guide us, and I have a friend that I haven't seen in some time that lives in the Old Woods. Perhaps we could stay there.
Kind of friend.
A friend of mine. He's a satyr, and he tried to warn the young folks from going into Demetria's domain, but you know, they were drunk on wine, and he wasn't very successful with that. But he's a friend.
Sounds like a nice guy, but I'd say like let's just get to the sour vintage and you know chill out there.
Oh. Sounds good.
Okay.
Hey.
Welcome, Solano Dale.
Yeah. Hello. We survived, and I on the bug.
He bought a Minotaur.
Now he's bound to me. That's how I phrase it. I'm not going to say slavery. I'm not going to say that.
Yeah. He just has a contract for the ownership of a Minotaur. That's all.
Yeah. It's like,
that's interesting.
Yeah, it's not like I did it on purpose. It's like, he literally made our escape plan worse. Yeah, it's like, Mar just like, he just tried to escape, did not do it very well.
Well, do we guys want to, like, go to this little hut of some random satyr that we don't know?
It's not like the satyr's gonna hurt us. I don't know, it's better, like, being in the house is better than being...
Never know. Can't trust those guys.
Hey, I
mean, you're kind of going through, unless you go a really long way around the river or around the mountains, you're kind of going through the Old Woods no matter which way you slice it.
I kind of trust Laureus. I mean, he's like stuck around.
He hasn't let us do a death trap yet, so we're good.
Not yet. Held so right like, now.
And it's like we push him in the river.
Who's helping Laureus navigate the Old Woods?
Is it nature or perception?
I mean, I have a good keen sense of smell to make sure that, you know, there's nothing coming towards us.
I got, like, I'm just keeping an eye out to make sure we don't get murdered by animals again.
Okay, so, yeah. Zark, give me a survival check.
Smell check.
Probably not gonna be good.
Okay.
Welcome to D&D.
We all die.
He smells up the dirt.
So as you are traveling through, oh, you did have Kyrah with you. As you are traveling through the Old Woods, you now have Bullbug in tow, as well as Laureus.
And Kyrah.
Of course, Kyrah.
Oh yeah, she also played the music for the stuff. She was obviously with us.
Uh-huh. Let me just do a... How about, Zark, you roll me a... D100. Okay. Um, So you're not quite sure if you're going in the right direction, but you smell the sea to your right, so you figure you're kind of going in that way. But Laureus is a little bit lost too. I mean, he knows he's in the old woods, but you haven't even come to the river yet. So you're just kind of making your way, looking for the river. But, you know, it's kind of that where an hour goes by and you're still like, where's this? We should have passed the river by now. And a group of, I'm going to activate this scene here. A group of men and women, all suffering from serious looking and apparently recent wounds, approaches your party. One man at the front of the band motions for his fellows to stop and calls out to you for aid.
Is the wounds of natural? Real?
Let's see. Let me just make sure I get all these guys out here first. So this
Jeff,
is...
that roll is to see if I can sense any animosity from them or any ill intent. I'm trying to size up their demeanor, so it might be more difficult.
Sure. Give me 1 second. Let's see.
Sounds good, boss.
Okay. So yeah, they definitely look like their wounds are real. They seem a little bit desperate, a little bit scared.
What's got you all scared?
Well, you see, we need help. We were trying to stop a band of centaurs, but the ambush went poorly. We're all really hurt, and they're after us. We could use your help. Please, join us before the centaurs arrive.
Why is a centaur all the way down here?
Where?
It's south. Basically, I thought they were in the plains.
Oh, yeah, you're right. This is,
it's like we're in the forest area. Not easy to run through.
Basically. Oh, yeah, you're right. I looked at the wrong, table.
Okay, sense.
I'm gonna retcon it. Yep, I'm gonna retcon it because these guys aren't really. So scratch the whole bandit thing. If one day you're in the plains and you run into that, that's why. Man, my tokens are acting real funny too. Okay, here we go. This is what I get for doing random encounters.
It works. You just have to sometimes. Fix them when they don't make sense.
Well, and some of these freaking tokens aren't disappearing for me. The whole game is messed up. Okay. You hear the sounds of angry shouting just beyond a nearby hedge. Peering through, you can see a strange headless creature with a single gray eye and mouth on its chest. The Cyclops appears to be screaming at itself and cursing its own stupidity. It stands over a broken human body and clutches at the lifeless arms.
Guys.
What? And he sees you.
Oh.
Hey. No.
I'm going to try and hide.
What? It's you. You're going to try to kill me because I'm just a stupid monster. I know you will. You just see my big eye and...
Why did you kill that person?
He was my friend. Listen. You... It's your fault. You made me do this. You see me as a monster, and I knew he saw me as a monster, too.
See you as a monster? I don't think you should be killing people.
What? You think I killed him? Oh, of course you do. The monster killed him. Look at the monster with his big eye just ramping through the forest. You're
hanging on to its dead body.
Yeah. He was my friend, and he just starts...
I'm so sorry.
Bring him back. Bring him back.
We will. It's going to take a few days.
Days? Bring him back now. He's clearly starting to get agitated. He's like, kind of like being a little destructive the way he's moving his body and like pushing on nearby hedges and trees and such.
Listen, we're friends of Cyclops. We've helped out many giants and Cyclops. We can help you too.
I don't believe you. They've tricked me that way before. You creatures, you. And he looks at Saren. You humans.
Delano, what was that that Cyclops that we helped out?
King, Forest King.
Yeah, the Forest King.
Let me find my notes notebook because I have all my school stuff out.
Oh no, school stuff does not help.
Listen, when you're learning two world languages at the same time as trying to get licensed to teach them both, your mind has become scrambled eggs.
Crayon.
King Crayon.
Crayon, yes! King Crayon, have you not heard of the tale of King Crayon? We made him king. Or, well, sort of king, but...
Oh, so you're not just fey creatures. You're powerful, huh? So powerful you could look past a one-eyed monster. So powerful you could bring my friend back.
You're not a monster.
I don't think he's coming back. Wait, is he dead? Is your friend still alive?
Go ahead and make a medicine check. Yep, you are very aware that he is dead, and he's been dead for at least an hour.
You can let go of him. Pretty sure he's been dead for an hour.
Oh, I'm getting that same error now. Oh, there we go.
Yep.
We might not be able to bring him back, but we can bring you more friends.
That's what you want, friends? I don't make friends easily. You
right.
Do not understand. He was my only friend. And he picks up one of the broken limbs from this creature and starts to make his way towards you. Roll for initiative. Oops, this guy is not in there. I'm gonna remove him. There we go.
As we do this, I'm gonna yell out, "I'll be your friend."
All right, Kyrah excitedly whips out her instrument. Saren, you're up.
Oh. Oh, it's like, well, we didn't help much. All we did was break the monster's heart. We're not pretty sure if he murdered him or not by accident.
Now we'll see the system really slog down as we go into battle here. Saren, what do you want to do?
Is he attacking us?
He is. He's moving towards you with a cut-off limb of a dead merchant.
Okay. Well, I'm going to mark him, see if this works. Art is clever as the gods.
Wow.
Hear anything. Right. Nope. Yeah, there is noise coming out of it. Okay. Welcome. Now I stab him with the Myikula. Is it hit? I can't tell.
It has in the chat that you have to click advantage. I don't know what the fast is.
Okay.
I don't know why it didn't speed through that.
I'll just click the that's normal.
Yep. Alright. That's a hit. Now you hit damage. Normal.
So weird. Doesn't do automatic right now.
Yeah, I don't know. It keeps going back and forth. It kind of decides when it wants to.
And I think I get my sneak attack because of the mark.
Because you have advantage.
Advantage.
Yep. Normal.
There you go.
Stab him in the eye.
Alright. Bullbug, he happily runs over to this guy. And he, what does he got? He has his gore feature, since he probably doesn't have a weapon yet. Does anyone give him a weapon?
Nah. We gave him an axe. Well, we never bought it. We just went into the town, considering what we did.
All right. Does he still? No, he doesn't have advantage, does he? Or does everyone have advantage for the round?
Everyone's got advantage.
Yeah, gotcha. Yeah, yep, I know. Sounds just a little slow. Lorius plays his. Let's see. No, he's just going to shoot a bow at him. He's going to stay back. But he's got a little short bow. So he whips out his little short bow and hits with a 22. Glorious, my man.
Nice.
All right. Good he's job, much Glorious. More agitated now. He targets you, Saren. And okay. He...
And I never healed. Let's do this.
Okay. He tries to grab you. And fails! Yeah, that actually played the right sound effect. So that was a epic fail. So describe how he epically failed to grab you.
He... I'm near Stump and Anzunk. I duck out of the way and he grabs the stunk and just breaks the stump.
All right, and he gets furious as he sees that you are not a stump. Zark, you're up.
We're going to smack him in the face with Pythor's hammer.
Nice. Some of them are fast-forwarding.
We're going to do it again.
Yeah, some you can actually see the damage.
Yep. So he rears up and hollers out.
Yep. And I'm good.
Okay.
Solano.
Solano Dare, are you with us?
Yeah. Yes. Sorry, I had to turn the music down. It was too loud.
That's okay.
How long do we have advantage for on the side of you, Sark?
It's me. It's like it goes until the end of my next turn.
Oh.
So I can only mark him once, but it works pretty well if it's a whole party attacking the same person.
Well, I've got... Let me see if this will work. I think I'll keep the advantage up with guiding.
Yep. Advantage and that guiding bolt.
No, guiding bolt's just the next attack roll. So I will cast. Does he only see through his one eye in the front?
Yeah.
Cool.
Wow. Choose one creature to make a constitution save. He succeeds.
He succeeded. Yep, that's fine. I tried.
Yeah, it would have been funny, but his eyeball's too good for some reason.
Yep.
He's got too much ball in his eye. Alright, that's it for Solano for now.
Okay. We've got Kyrah. She continues to play her Song of Reroll, Perseverance, I believe. Yeah, sure. Oh no, that's the unconscious one. The heroism one. So you all get bravery and you can reroll a dice if you want.
Okay.
Saren is up.
I've got my advantage, but I'm still going to stab him in the face. Stab.
Stabby, stab, stab.
I can't. So why does it only do that to me?
I don't know.
Yeah, it's like... normal.
That's a hit.
Okay, damage. No.
And there you go.
I got my friendly units by me. Sneak attack.
You got it. Anything else there?
Nope. I'm just going to brace in case he grabs me again.
Okay. Your new Minotaur Bullbug friend tries to gore him once again with his horns and hits for wowzers.
Wow.
He's my new pocket Pokemon.
Yeah, that was great, Bullbug.
Nice.
So you see his horns just kind of get stuck in there a little bit, and he rips his flesh as he tears his horns out. Glorious. Had a pretty good shot before. We're going to try a short bow once again. And that nice. Hits. And this guy is up again. He rears up. And this time he attacks. He goes for Bullbug.
Disadvantage.
Yep.
Okay. Really? Is that broken? Nope, that's a real one. Okay. He fails again, so he went to go grab Saren, and Saren rolled out of the way, and he grabbed a stump. He goes to grab Bullbug. Bullbug sidesteps it, and he grabs a thorny bush and feels his, hand just grab bush instead of Bullbug, so he's just super upset. He does have a multi-attack feature, but let's see.
Can you only do it once?
Yeah, he can only do it under certain conditions, and that's if he has someone grappled, which he does not. So, Zark is up.
So his only thing is if he can grab us, he'll punch us to death.
Jump up and start slamming him with my hammer.
Excellent.
Jump up, slam in the face, jump up again, slam in the face.
Ah!
Throw my shield up, ready for actual fight to happen.
All right. Solano Deo.
I know.
Solano is still reeling from the failure of the spell. So, it's going to make things a little easier on himself and his self-esteem and cast a firebolt this round. What?
Crit!
Yeah.
Crit!
Yeah.
So this blast of fire shows up right through. It's coming into sundown, so it lights up the area quite a bit. You see him smacking at his one eye as the embers burn a little bit at his cornea. Anything else?
No, that's it.
All right. Kyrah excitedly riding Solano Deo with the fireball. Saren's up.
Okay, hopefully this kills him. Do the rerolls song, I guess.
Yeah, she's doing the reroll song.
Okay, let's make sure. Yep. Normal hit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Normal. Sneak attack. Die.
Describe your kill.
I just go below him and stab him right through the eye. Kind of like at an angle, like going up into him.
And you hear him just like holler out as he like collapses in a gurgle of spit and blood.
Not a good friend.
I wanted to be your friend!
He did not want other friends. Did he have anything on him besides an arm?
I don't think my loot button's working, but we'll try it. Nope. He didn't have anything on him, but the merchant that he disembodied had some things on him.
Disarmed.
He had some hide armor. He had two daggers. A short bow. And let's see. He had 19 drachma.
That's barely anything.
Okay. So the daggers we should probably give to Bullbug since he doesn't have any weapons.
also the bow.
I agree.
And I'm just going to take that drachma. It's literally nothing that nice. Use the money to buy Bubba. So you can, yeah, I guess melee weapons make more sense with them anyway, but it's always good to have a bow.
I'm gonna go like stand on the Cyclops' chest and pull down like his one eyelid.
Oh right.
Put the coin on top of his eyelid.
He's a monster, right?
He's not a monster.
I know, but he's considered a monster race.
He is a blemmies. He is considered a giant in the cyclope kind of range. Yeah, they are cyclopes that have no heads, instead the single great eye and a nose and a mouth in the center of their chest.
I'm just thinking, does his eye consider a magic heart?
Ooh, good question. Let me pop into the Discord and see if I can answer that authoritatively. In the meantime, you can give like a... Gosh, I guess it would be like an Arcana check?
A row with Arcana. Damn it. Well, I can ask others to look out over it too. See, because they have better magic than me. And I'll give it a shot. But I just have an idea what to do with his body part.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we're looking at a blemish.
Blemish. Like a giant, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I think I will count it as a cyclope's eye, in which case it can be used as an ingredient for monster parts.
Yep. That's what I was thinking, taking his eye from armor or weapon.
It's part.
So, Saren, you could figure that the eye is could be used. Who else is interested in checking out this creature?
That'd be me.
Okay, Zark, give me a Arcana check. I'm trying to think if there's any other skill. Yep, you figure the eye is probably the best.
Long game they use. We just thinking about taking out the eye. It's most important part. Even then, my idea was to take the eye.
Does it tell you in the binder that I shared with you which parts you might?
Yes.
Does it?
Yeah. It doesn't tell us what you can get out of it. It just has
gotcha. Okay.
These are the things we're looking for.
Yeah, in that case, you know that the heart, the eye, and the eyelid are all usable parts.
We'll just take them.
Okay, whoever's taking them, it's one of each.
I'm just going to... everybody look away. Yes, I plunge a knife into his chest and cut its heart out.
Just put down the... like put down what you grabbed in the inventory in case we forget.
Yep, mark it down.
Always.
Yep. Eye, heart, eyelashes.
By the way, I had some Minotaur horns that Vulcan was working on. How's that going?
Yeah, let me check this calendar here. Yeah, it's not ready yet. Wait, maybe that a date. Let's see what that date is. Oh, that's a different date. When did you send that away? That was around the coronation of the queen? That you sent that off?
I think it was a little before then, but yeah, somewhere right around there.
Okay, yep. You figure it'll be due in the next 2 to 3 days.
Cool. So yes, on to the place where we can take a nap and heal up from that giant cyclops bite.
None of us got hurt.
Lorius goes up to you, Saren, and says, "Wow, that was so brave. You went right up to him, and he's like five times your size. That was amazing, Saren."
Okay.
Can you tell me how you overcome your fears? I had to stay back. I mean, did you see my arrow shots? I got him with my arrow.
Yeah, you're doing a lot better than you were. That's good, at least.
I'm doing better than I was before?
You missed a lot.
Oh, well, thank you, Saren. I appreciate you noticing that. I've really been working on my aim. I want you heroes to do well, and I'm so excited to be part of your journey.
Yep.
It wow. Seems like with Ashaya gone, it feels like there's a something missing.
There's a hole.
Yeah, but
that needs to be filled in my heart.
No.
Well,
it's like we need someone else that can fly, but you know, none of us, we're all land people. Except that guy who's high on salts, but that doesn't matter.
Well, I haven't seen him since I joined up with you all, but my friend, he can't fly, but he was studying magic like Ashaya.
Hmm.
I hope it didn't get him.
Flying thing.
Don't what?
But the flying thing is very important.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe he learned some way to fly, but when I knew him, he couldn't fly.
Hmm. Is this, let's put the options on the table. We'll learn if he can fly or not.
Oh, is that a prerequisite for joining your party now?
No, but we're just trying to see if we can fill the hole in our
hearts.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Yeah, it's hard. I do hope, you know, Ashaya finds what she needs and perhaps joins us before the end of the Oath of Peace to fight off the Titans once and for all.
We'll see. So, let's head, lead the way to the house.
Okay, I'll try. Can I get someone to help? I'm still not quite sure where we are. So he starts to lead the way. Who's helping him? Saren?
Just looking around.
Yeah, Saren, give me a nature check.
No. Not nature. No. Why are we bad at nature?
Yeah, Saren.
Better than I was.
Yeah, you look around and you have no idea where you are. Lorius is going to do a little nature check. Let's see if... yeah, Lorius is like... He's not quite sure where we are, but he knows which way east is. So he says, "Well, I guess we'll keep heading east till we find the river, and you all continue on that way." Let's see here. I'm gonna try to preload this scene for a moment.
Yeah, it's easier loading these maps. I don't know why that one map has caused problems.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to stop doing updates, and in fact, it's supposed to be the stable version of the 0.8 series, and I think I might have to clean up a lot of things. I've got a lot of things. I get overexcited with all the things, so I might have to clean it up. I was even thinking, like, what if I just erase the whole frickin' world and just reload things, because, I don't know. I probably just have to... What do you call it? Compendomize scenes or whatever. Anyway,
if you erase everything and restart. I gotta start calling you Patrick Rothfuss.
Is that the author that needs to write that book that he hasn't written?
Yes.
What is that? Don't tell me. I don't remember the name of it.
The name of the Wind series.
Yeah.
The King Killer Chronicles. Yeah.
He's dragging his feet still, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm going to gather you all up. Hopefully that scene preloaded. So you make your way through the woods some more. And Lorius gets excited as you cross the river. And he says, "Ah, yes, we're close. I know that he's around this area. And last I heard, there was a magic he was chasing. that hopefully
allows him to fly.
Maybe it allows him to fly. I don't know. So you find yourselves on this path in the old woods, and Lorius starts to get excited. I'm gonna pause it for a second, but you hear some commotion through the woods, seemingly in the way of the path that you're on.
Cool.
Can we see anything, or just we can just hear some shit going on?
You hear some like energetic crackling energy. You hear the telltale signs of what you know to be goatlings. They're making yo mama jokes. They're cackling in the way that they cackle, and that kind of thing. You also see the hands of Kentamane holding up this path, and it's kind of at the treetop level.
Cool.
Yeah.
Nice place to build a house.
So Lorius, he starts to get a little nervous as he hears the commotion, and he says, the heart of the old woods is up here. It's known as a source of energy for fey creatures and a source of wisdom for the old woods. I knew that my friend was studying the heart of the old woods and doing a lot of meditation and studying. Not really sure what he was doing. It all seemed very strange to me, but the last time I saw him, he was in this area, and he may still be here.
You think he's in trouble?
I mean, if you listen, that sounds like Lutheria's. Attacking us when we were in the Mossy Temple.
I agree.
We think we should run in. We should probably run in there and get help him as fast as we can. So.
Yeah.
Let's run.
Bullbug says, I like a good fight.
I'm gonna dash.
Okay, I'll just assume that you all can make it there.
Technically, that is my dash.
So what you see is this field of energy. It's almost like the brambles in the center are on fire, but the fire is this blue electric energy. You see a creature with horns and hooves that is surrounded on all sides. Mike, describe your character.
Ooh. I am a satyr from afar. Normally, a day is always a bad day. Something's always trying to kill me. How much more do you want to go into?
What were you going to say, Bob?
Like what you look like.
I just said kill it.
Oh.
So,
I mean.
Kill it?
I thought you were raising your hand for something.
No, I'm the one trying to kill him right now.
Yeah, all right.
Solano thinks that is the most angry satyr he has ever seen.
Reminds me of his uncle.
So yeah, roll initiative.
Bumped into my dice.
Solano Deo and Mike, did you get prompted to roll?
I found it.
Oh, okay.
You rolled it.
Good.
It looks orange for some reason.
So Kyrah stays back and plays. She actually just starts scribbling and talks about the old woods and the arcane energy coming from this strange canopy pathway that she'd never seen before. This creature comes at you. Is it Alistair?
Alistair.
And tries to stab you with a dagger. And hits for 5 points of damage. You hear her friends cackling. This particular little goatling comes up to you. If I can get it to actually... Yeah, it might just have to share a different space. But that one... they all have these little slings, and they're just like whipping these little rocks at you. So you're just getting pelted from all sides. One of them gets you real good, straight in the spine. Saren, you are up.
Okay, 5, 10, 15, 20. I can't get close enough, but I'm gonna go over here.
So you are next to a maenad.
Oh.
You got maenads?
Are those the things that basically give birth to those goatlings?
Yeah, kind of. They're like these weird cross creatures.
Okay.
They seem very sexual in the image.
Yeah. But they gave birth to those disgusting things, so they must die.
Sure.
Yeah. Oh, God. Anyway, I critted with the... Oh, no. I can hit the sneak button twice.
Wowzers. Yeah, so you just described all of that. You just walk up and...
Just yip. Like stab her in like real vital. It's like, yeah. It's like popped up. The stab right in the neck, but still alive somehow.
All right.
Yep, in my turn, but that was pretty cool.
They respond. This one runs up to you. And in response, let me see. Yeah, this one goes into a wild dance, kind of where it was, but it's kind of dancing in this general area. And you all, well, Mike, Alistair, and Saren need to make a... Oh, it says you already did it. So you succeeded, Saren.
Nice.
Yeah.
Mike, you need to give me a wisdom or a charisma saving throw.
Do it now.
Oh, charisma is his thing, so he's probably going to be fine.
Oh, that means bard or warlock or sorcerer.
Or good looking guy.
Where are...
So if you click on under attributes, yep.
Yeah,
yep, you are totally fine. So you see... Let me just check for a second to see if these other creatures... charisma. Okay, that one's fine. This one. Okay, so just this creature just starts dancing around in this crazy formation. Oh, this one probably needs to do the... Okay, so one of them, this little goatling, is transformed by this. So the goatling goes into a frenzied dance, and let's see, oops, that should be a 10, and it is, oh, he's fine, but this one kind of starts to go into a crazy dance as he giggles and laughs, and that's what happens, I guess, they just start dancing. This one, though, is unfazed, targets Alistair over there with his sling attack, and misses so badly, he hits this maenad over here for 5 damage. That didn't take your damage away, did it, Mike? I don't think so.
Nope.
All right. Bullbug busts in. How much hit speed? He's got 30 feet. 25. Oh, he can make it right about there. And he targets the one that he has advantage with his gore attack. Oh, he's got daggers now. Thanks, somebody, for giving him daggers. Yeah, so he hits for 6 points, and I don't think he has... oh, nope. He doesn't have multi-attack with the daggers. Okay.
Sure, then gore.
Zark is up.
Hey. I am going to conveniently run through... Oh, don't do that. Alright, we're going there. Getting here. I don't know who you are, but it seems like you're killing the things that want to kill us, so... Let's smack this one a couple times. Oh.
Ouch.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, crit fail table. You pull a muscle in your upper body, you'll roll disadvantage until your next short rest or heal.
Jesus.
Well, you pulled that hamstring too hard. That's what happened.
Yeah. Bullbug says, you gotta stretch first.
Well, I thought I was all stretched out from all the walking we did, but apparently not my upper body. God.
No, it's like you're all...
No, it does say upper body. Left. That's funny. All right. This one makes its way towards Alistair over here. And it will also... just attack you with two daggers. Bada boom. With a miss. Second one is a bad miss. Kind of whips around. Ends up hitting this little goatling over here. Maybe. It won't let me target it. But let's see. Damage is 8. Why is it doing that? Goatling. Okay. Minus 8 as that goatling gets slashed from a swing. This little goatling over here can make it... Oh, how far can you make a little goatling? To Zark. And it will try to bite you. Misses. Oops, did I have the other one? That's fine. And then lastly... Oh, no, there's two more. This one here sees you guys coming in. Goes after you, Saren, with a bite. Nasty little bite. Misses.
He bites someone else.
I guess, yeah. He must have... Oh, I still had that one targeted. This one here can make it to Zark. Or Saren. I'll say he goes after Zark. With a bite. With a crit! You got critically bit as you were pulling a muscle in your upper body and trying to readjust. This little fucker comes up to you and grabs your calf muscle. This satyr in the middle.
Alright. I don't know who you are, but I'm guessing you're not here to kill me this time. Let's talk in just a few minutes. And... let's roll this one. Casting this about...
Oh, I can see the target. See the...
Yeah, it's cool. I think that's an update.
Yeah, I can see where he's targeting, basically where the bubbles are. But I can't see the target spell zones. I'm just...
There's a word right here that I can't click through. There. Did that? No.
You might. Did you click it? Or is it... No, that's good.
Jeff, make these words go away.
What words are you talking about?
Yeah, you gotta explain what's happening.
I got looks like a goal bar that has... 1 out of 2, 0 out of 0.
I have no idea what you're referencing.
You don't see that on the upper right hand next to the chat window? It won't let me click through it.
No, I have no idea what you're referencing.
Let me try and zoom out then.
If you have a scroll mouse, you can zoom out with a scroll.
That might work.
So you're trying to cast Fireball. Streak flashes from your pointing finger to a point you choose within range, and then blossoms with a low roar into an explosion of flame.
Okay.
Are you just trying to... Okay, that's where you... Okay, you hit them.
All right. Yep, you killed two of them. A flame erupts into the forest. Several, or two of them are dead, two of them are hurt pretty bad. And now there's a ball of flame.
Sweet.
Anything else?
No.
Did you figure out whatever question about some gold bars you had?
Nope, it is just still there.
I don't know.
I zoomed out to get around it.
Take a screenshot for me. Okay. Okay, this Maenad doesn't have disadvantage, it just has advantage for other people to attack it, right?
Yeah.
Okay. It's going to double dagger with its daggers at you, Saren. Oops, I had way too many targets. Wow.
It's like throwing all the daggers.
Yeah. How do I clear my targets? Goatling trickster, huh? Oh, maybe I do have those targeted. Man, target feature's broken. No. Okay, and he's gonna get one more attack on you. So with another dagger, there we go. That's only one. All right. This one here that just got fried a little bit runs over to you, knowing that you are the source of its fryness, and attacks twice. What?
Disadvantage.
Damn it. Hold on. Let me just... Fine. You just saved Mike 7 hit points. Okay, Solano Deo. You see a fire erupt from this creature in the center as several goatlings turn into tenderized, crispy goatlings.
That's kind of crazy, but the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure my new satyr person is okay at hit points. So I'm going to cast Healing Word on them as a bonus action.
Oh, on a stranger?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, he's fighting goatlings, so he's an ally at least.
He's helping us! Alright, he heals. Oh my god, that's a crap roll. But it's hit points. And I got a guy in front of me that's near death, so let's try to firebolt his ass. And that looks like a miss.
I don't think it worked.
Hmm.
You have to hit attack in the chat. Did it work on your end?
No, that's weird.
I'll do it for you.
Okay.
Nope, that's a miss.
Alright, it turns over then.
Alright. This little goatling bastard is way over here. He's gonna make his way to Zerk. I wish I could move them different in the box. I'm gonna move him over there just because I don't want him blending with the other one. And he tries to bite your ass with a 22. That's a hit. That's all he gets, though. So you see these little fuckers dancing around your legs. Lorius, not quite sure how to help, but doesn't like these guys at all, comes in here, targets the one that he gets advantage on, and short bowser with a hit. Oops, he doesn't.
Yeah, that was 9 on the little girl thing.
Yeah, I'm going to reverse that. Reverse. Oops, wrong reverse. Gosh, dang it.
Kill her again.
Yeah, I will kill her again. Reverse this one. My chat's all jacked. There we go. Okay. Kyrah! Mike, to help you out here, Kyrah is a bard and the goddess of music, and she is going to put... her job is to kind of keep track of y'all, right? The epic tales of all of your journeys. Sometimes she does that, but sometimes she puts down her journal and whips out her musical instruments, and she's currently whipping out her musical instrument and playing a song. And the song that she is playing is a song of heroism, which, until the end of her next turn, all allies who hear her song can re-roll one dice roll of their choice. So I call it the re-roll song. This one here targets you, Mike, with its double dagger feature. Misses, and still has this guy tracked. Okay. Takes another dagger. And misses again.
Lucky.
This one runs around to... Oh, man, I don't really want to get it mixed up with all the others, but... yeah, we'll say it goes over to here, maybe? And targets you, Mike, with a slingshot. And this is... All right, Saren is up.
Okay, time to kill more creatures. Okay, gonna kill that little goatling because I killed its mom. Just like stab him. And I killed him.
Nice. Stab a little goatling. Little goatling baby.
Yep.
They're like, meh!
Well, that's one down. And now I just, like, turn around and aim for the, like, keep an eye on the other ones now.
Okay. This one sees this Minotaur heading for it and double daggers it. Hits Bullbug for 5 and again for 7 hit points of damage.
Barely hurts him.
Bullbug, cool. In turn, uses his dagger with a crit. Hits it for 10, slashes right into its maenad belly. Zark, you see your new Bullbug friend tearing it up. What do you do?
I yell, "Don't touch Bullbug!" And I... I've got disadvantage unless I heal, right?
Yes.
You do.
You can risk it. You can risk it.
Give me 2 seconds. Let me see.
1 Mississippi. 2 Mississippi.
Oh, it's freaking 1 action. Oh, well. Well. I am going to heal myself.
Okay.
With a cure wounds. Oh, I don't know why it healed the maenad. That was not supposed to happen.
Which one? Okay, I got you.
That one, yeah. Alright. So I healed myself for a total of 2, but...
Now you don't have disadvantage.
Yes. So, we're good there.
Okay. This one targets Alistair once again. Misses. Second dagger. Hits for 7 piercing. This little goatling bastard comes at you, Alistair, and tries to bite you. Misses. This little goatling bastard comes all the way around to the top here. And tries to bite you along the way.
Wait, did it just leave my
It sure reach? Fucking did.
And I think it was, and it did mine, so I'm
sure did.
Die. Well, I didn't target him. Oh, I forgot. They're all the same to me. I think that hit.
Yeah, 13 would hit, so I think your first attack.
You have the 12.
I don't know, what was the damage? So Yiklawa was a 25, so 12 damage. So yeah, he dead. Yeah. So whatever, Mike, whatever he did to you, did he bite you?
Yeah, but I think he missed.
We're going to find out. Yep, he missed anyway. Okay, so he goes to come at you and bite you, but he dies.
Woohoo!
And you're up.
Let's the good times rolling. Is it right click to target?
Or alt click. It's either double right click or alt click.
Alright. There's that.
Nice.
Cast that. Oh. That, all of those are actions.
Alright. You see this, like, weird purplish electrical energy kind of flash over the Maenad's eyes as they don't seem to care about their own life, and they target with their double knife attack once again, and you get hit twice from that one. And Solano Deo is up. You see your new friend or possible new ally is hurting pretty bad.
Yikes. Alright.
The guy we need to kill.
Or what?
The guy we need to kill.
Hmm? He's not...
We might need to kill him. Just saying.
Oh my god.
At least he's not metagaming.
Well, he's been fighting them off. I mean,
I know. Doesn't mean he's not going to turn on us afterwards. Keep that in mind. Be ready.
Yeah, it's like it's always happened. Don't let your heart open. They destroy it. They destroy it.
Well, he's healed for 5.
Oh. You can
and then and the one next to him that's near death. Let's see if I can hit him with a spell. Did that work?
Did you target him?
Yeah, you just gotta hit the attack button. Maybe that's what it is. If you don't target, I don't know.
I targeted him before the attack. Let me try for my character sheet.
Well, that's a hit. And the damage is 9. I'll just do it manually. They take 9 damage.
It's not dead.
No, it's close.
Shit. No, that's it for me.
Okay. This little bugger, again, you see this purplish, bluish light cover its eyes as if it doesn't care about its own life and tries to bite you, Alistair. And, I think Lorius, using his lovely short bow, makes an attack and gets that little guy pretty good. Kyrah continues playing her Song of Reroll. This one here, again, bluish purplish eyes as it dagger attacks this satyr twice, and satyr is down.
Yep. Not gonna let you die.
This trickster comes up here and targets the down satyr with a bite and successfully hits for 2 failed death save kind of deals. So the next hit, you are dead.
Okay, so I'm gonna right there. Target this one. Stab him.
That's a hit for 10.
Die. Well, I'm trying. It's like trying to stop him from killing him. So I'll end my turn.
Okay. This one here probably targets Bullbug over there. The double dagger with a crit. Bullbug takes 9 points of damage. Followed up with a 22 attack and another 8 points of damage. Bullbug responds. Pissed off. He, let's see. He's going to dagger and hits. And I think he can gore too. We'll say he can for now. And misses with his gore attack. Zark, you see this satyr, this with robed satyr with a cane of skulls just drop right in front of you.
Can I tell if he would be friendly?
What are you looking for?
I mean, I understand that he's fighting these things. Actually, you know what? I'd like to yell out to Lorius. Is this your friend?
Oh my god.
Lorius says yes.
Okay.
Okay. Hashtag,
so much better.
Hashtag, was that really a surprise?
Yeah, it's like he's literally a satyr. He's literally a satyr.
So I touch him in, like, on his shoulder. I don't want to, like, you know,
in a consensual manner.
Yes, like straight up on his.
If he was conscious, he would have consented.
And I just kind of like say a short prayer for him as he raises up a little bit.
Okay.
I think that other one is. Oh, I got rid of that. All right, well, that's not useful anymore. Yep, so that's it. That sounds good. And the next time somebody swings at him, it's going to be a disadvantage, just to throw that out there now.
Okay, this one's definitely swinging at him with a double knife attack disadvantage. A 17 at disadvantage. Well, well, well.
Liar.
I'm for real. Yeah, that was a... 11 and a 13. Wait. How did that work out? Because your AC is 15. I rolled disadvantage, which is 11. I'm confused why it still said it hits.
The fates are trying to kill me.
Well, I get that, but that really... Your armor class
you know,
is
Mike.
15.
This happened in the last game.
That shouldn't have hit. It said it hit. I think mm-hmm. there's something wrong with the auto target feature.
Okay. Give him those points back then.
Yeah. It doesn't even calculate. It didn't even calculate your points. It just added unconscious. That's weird. So, I don't know why it took that away, because it literally calculated the disadvantage, even though it was... A 13 and 11 rolled. It highlighted the 11, but then it said it was a 17. So where the hell did that come from? Oh, with the 11 plus... Oh, plus it's a multiplier. So it actually did hit because they've got a 4 and a 2 for the proficiency or whatever. So that was a 17. So you are unconscious.
Yeah. He made this stuff up last time, too.
Yep. I was there for it.
Oh, this goatling's gonna bite your ass, Zark, because he doesn't like that comment. And that's a hit for 7 points of damage.
What?
He wants a bite of those steamed hams.
What? Okay.
Alistair, I need a death saving throw.
Yikes.
Yeah.
Coming, bro.
They do not like you, Mike.
So it should be on the main page under attributes, and you just click death saves.
Click that button.
Where's attributes?
The far left on your character sheet.
Yeah, you just see.
You're just looking at the
just click the
stuff
name.
Under utility. I think it has it as well.
Yeah, you see attributes. It's just underneath resource.
Oops.
One.
Did it? Let me reset it because I did it wrong. Did you roll it?
I think so. It says mine is.
Yep, you're good.
Hidden from me.
Yep. Well, you can look at your sheet, but the others can't, so that's why I did that. So if you look at your sheet, you'll know what you got. The others will not.
Oh.
Yeah, keeping it secret. This guy's going to target Zark with his dagger.
You've added more shenanigans into this.
That's right.
Oh, yeah.
That's a double dagger attack.
So many knives.
So many knives. Solano Deo, you see your possible ally drop once again.
Yeah, what the frick? Okay. Well, that shit ain't gonna fly.
trying to find the spell. Fruit.
Healed.
Oh, bonus action, healing word. Badly injured guy over there.
Who are you attacking? Yeah, I don't know why your firebolt is broken.
Yeah, the other spells work.
Hmm.
The one, I have this one targeted here.
Let me just, I'm going to delete firebolt and add it to your sheet again real quick.
Okay.
See if that helps. Sorry, which one are you targeting? Okay. Let's see if we can get that firebolt working. There we go. That was me rolling it. I'll let you roll it since that was a
thank you.
Crit fail. So go ahead and roll firebolt again, because the last couple times it didn't auto roll. Huh. Well, that hits. Go ahead and roll damage. I'll make sure it applies.
Awesome.
Nice.
That was good.
Yeah, that was good.
And that's it for Solano Deo. I have one spell left and I'm tapped out, guys.
Okay, that one's near death. This one tries to bite you, Zark. And misses. Lorius targets the one that Solano Deo was just working on with a short bow. And misses. Lorius, do you have a multi-attack? No, you don't.
No, you don't.
Kyra plays harder and says, "The re-roll song," as she's playing her music.
Well.
This one actually turns towards Saren.
I'm gonna re-roll!
With a dagger attack and hits. Oops.
Did it just kill its friend?
Yeah, it was an accidental target. Yeah, this target thing is not working out for me so well. Okay. And we've got the trickster goatling here that targets you, Mike, with its sling. Oh, and hits a crit. Wow. So you take another rock to the face.
Was that with disadvantage?
Was it supposed to be?
Sure.
So
okay, yeah, because Dark's right there.
Just the one. Unless we're in a new... No, I haven't.
Yeah. Saren, you're up.
It's like... It's, I don't even know what class you are, but...
Most of them are close to dead. I think you guys got this.
Yeah, it's just like, we just have to make sure they don't kill him is the thing. Okay, so I'm just going to stab. Did I hit?
No, that's a miss.
Great. Well, I'm just going to target this one so someone can kill it. Nope, and I did missed. So nothing worked.
Okay, this one's going after Bullbug once again. With its double dagger attack. First one hits Bullbug for 5. Second one hits Bullbug for 6. He, in turn, takes his little dagger. Misses, and then he just gets frustrated and gores the F out of this fucking maenad and kills it. You see the horns just go right up through the throat and one of Bullbug, and he's trying to shake it off, and you see this like maenad like doing this marionette dance as he tries to shake it off of its horn. Zark.
Good Bullbug. Oh man. Got another unconscious dude, huh? I feel like this is all I'm going to do today.
Mike's like, "You invited me to play just to kill me?"
Right, just to kill me.
That sounds about right.
Yeah, that's what he does.
Reach out and touch me.
Reach out and touch me.
I didn't think it would do it. I'm healing him for 25.
Wow.
Whoa.
For some reason. Well, it
how
just
do you,
doesn't
How
work.
Do you know it's 25?
Lay on hands.
Oh, because you have a pool. Gotcha.
Yeah.
So he used the whole pool to make sure he doesn't get knocked out.
Well, to hope that he doesn't get knocked out.
Anything else, Zark?
You underestimate.
Nope. But the next time that he is attacked, it's going to be at disadvantage.
Well, lucky you, it's right now.
Yep.
Okay.
Lucky Mike.
Disadvantage. 15 hits still. Another dagger for disadvantage and misses. These maenads really like their knives and they're doing pretty good. This one here is going to target you, Zark, with its bite. And misses. And Mike is up.
Do I have to initiate my copy spell before I know the outcome of the first one?
The twinned spell?
Yeah.
When you cast a spell that targets only one creature and doesn't have a range of self, you can spend a number of sorcery points equal to the spell's level to target a second creature. So your original question of do you need to know the outcome?
Yeah.
I don't think so. I think you can just cast it and then say, you know, I twin the spell. So even if you miss, I think you can still target another creature.
Ooh.
Yeah.
I like that thinking for once. Let's do it.
So that's a miss.
And it has to be a different one?
I believe so. Let me double check. You can spend a number of sorcery points equal to the spell's level. What's the spell's level?
Level 1.
Okay, so you use one sorcery point, and you could target a second creature in range with the same spell. And that's also a miss.
Can I re-roll the last one?
You can. Yeah. Kira's got that song going, and you get a re-roll.
Wow. You just click it again?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's roll again. Yeah.
That's a hit for 13 points of fire damage.
Not dead. Damn.
No, they're all really close. All right. This one, blue purple eyes, targets you. It's like barely hanging on. There's blood, guts, and gore everywhere as it hits you with its knife. Spins around, it hits you again for more and more damage. Solano Deo, you see this strange thing. This satyr keeps getting healed, and yet these creatures with no care for their own lives just seem to go after him over and over and over.
I'm sick of that shit.
They just really do not like him. What did you do to them?
That's what I want to know.
Yeah, it's like,
right. I'll try a firebolt again against one of them.
Okay.
Let's see if it works.
Huh.
It was in my little tool, my little action bar in the bottom, so it might be left over from the last sheet, but we'll see how the updated one works.
So are you casting it again? Is that what you're saying?
Yep, it still does the same.
Yeah.
Did that work?
No, it didn't auto roll. But it did it when I did it. But I did it from your sheet, probably.
I just did it from my sheet, too.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Huh. I wonder what's going on. Who are you targeting? Okay. Yeah, that's an AC 14. So go ahead and click on attack in the chat bar. We'll see if you get at least 14. Click the attack button, maybe.
I did hit the attack button.
Really?
What's going on with this machine?
Oh, well, I got a crit for you.
Yeah!
So that's 24 points of damage. I don't know why that's not... yeah, so your firebolt flies through the air and kills that one right next to okay. Alistair over there. Anything else?
No, that's it for now.
Okay. He's going to try to bite you and misses Zark. Lorius is going to move next to Bullbug here. Actually, I think he can go a little further, and he's going to try to launch an arrow at that one beyond, and hits very nicely, and doesn't quite kill, though, but really close. Kyrah, rocking the re-roll song. I want to rock and re-roll all night.
And watch you hit shit every day.
This one here, I think he's probably going to go after the satyr with the dagger. Does he have a normal roll? Okay. 25 hits with a single dagger slice, takes a round, whips another dagger slice and another hit, and again, the satyr is down.
Wow. Well, you're not going frontline anytime soon.
This goatling comes after you, Saren, with a bite and hits for 7 points of damage.
Ah, man.
You are up.
Oh, gotta take them down. Gonna try to mark them up. Oh, come on. Okay. Let's try to take her.
Oops, not so clever. Hold on, let me take that effect away. Okay.
Yeah, I didn't see it go off. Okay. Gonna stab. I hit it twice. Nope. Yeah, it hits. Friendly units right there.
Mm-hmm.
Yay.
Yay.
And we finally killed them. So close to dying, but it's worth it to kill them.
Anything else, Saren?
Nope, I'm good. Let's hope I survive the next round.
Okay. Bullbug comes up. He stomps over his dead thing there. Targets this little bastard that seems to be targeting Zark. And uses his dagger. And hits. And takes his little gore horns. And tries to stab the little bastard too. And kills it. So you see, not only is there a dead maenad kind of hanging from one of his horns, but now there's a dead goatling hanging from the other horn. Zark, you got a little goatling by you. You got
good job, Bullbug. Smash.
That's a hit and a kill.
And I'm going to move a couple feet to my right, and I'm going to swing my hammer at him. Oh. Swung at the wrong one.
That's all right. 17 hits for 10 damage, so that's a kill.
So I just like backhand the one with my hammer. Freaking run over to the maenad, and I'm just like, stuck in! And just like jump up in the air and slam it right down its head.
All right. Yeah. Death saving throw, Alistair.
All right.
You cleared it, right? You cleared it, right? Zeros again.
All right. Oh, yeah, it was supposed to be cleared. Oh, you're good. It cleared. I think it automatically does it. Okay, Solano Deo. You see one little goatling left, a bunch of dead goatlings and maenads, and an unconscious satyr that seemed to have been magical in nature.
Well, guess what? I have one first-level spell slot left.
You're gonna use it to
Yeet. Alright, where's the alive goatling?
Right behind him.
Alright, let's see if the spell hit, if the spell works. We'll see.
Did you target him?
Yeah. click him.
Yeah, he's targeted. He's looks like he's got the ring on him. I can't zoom into the map for some reason, but it looks like it's got him targeted. We'll see.
He's the middle.
I don't know why that's not working, but a 7 is what I rolled for you, which is a miss.
That's okay.
Oh, the animation worked.
There we go.
Anything else?
That's it.
Okay, Lorius pops up over here, tries to target that little bastard with his short bow, and hits.
Yay.
And kills him.
Nice shot, Lorius.
Lorius is on fire today.
Maybe we can find a thing. These things have any swords on them. But nah, that's not the point right now. Must be staying alive.
All right, it gets quiet.
So it's not today.
So before this introduction happens, how about a break?
Sure. Take 5?
Sounds good.
Okay.
Not that I feel like we're going to be introduced to anybody in specific.
Really wasn't sure if they were gonna kill you.
They're not the ones meant to kill me. So I cannot die.
I'm gonna pop you up here for the conversation. Did you happen to see how I animated all of their tokens?
Yeah. Well,
I know it's kind of hard to see,
them. Yeah, I saw that one.
Oh, Zark, let me get his animated version.
Boo.
He's got an animated version. It's just. There we go.
Zark, is Zark the son of Pythor?
Yeah.
So Pythor got it on with a Minotaur?
Yeah, probably. It's weird though, some of the times when I change the image, it doesn't show up like it should. Unless I refresh, I guess? I don't even know. Man, I feel a little bit like I've been slacking.
Ooh, get on it.
You're good.
Well, I mean, we used to have like 7 to 10 stream watchers each week, and I think with the inconsistency and players dropping in summertime, it just kind of fell apart.
Oh, for real? You had watchers?
I did, yeah. A few.
I used to talk to our old watchers, which was me when I looked at the video again.
Yeah, I don't want to be, you know, the DM that always stops at level 5 or 6 or whatever. It gets exponentially complicated as you get past level 5, though.
Nah.
We'll see. This particular chapter that you guys are on is the most complex, and then I think it gets a little easier, so...
Because of plot devices.
Yeah.
Good old Greco-Roman story talk. Where? Get over from a small village. And then he realizes he's got superpowers. But he got those superpowers from one god having sex with a bunch of other gods that he didn't belong porking. And that's just the background.
No idea what I walked into.
Oh, just a basic stereotypical Greco-Roman hero.
Oh, got it.
Or they have father issues. It's one or the other.
All the gods just wander around having sex with everything.
Nope.
I don't have father issues.
Yet.
Oh, I definitely do.
I was gonna say, you're like trying to save your father from his own... things.
Drunken stupidness,
Father,
yeah.
Why are you an asshole? It's just the way I am, son.
Alistair, by the way, these hands that come up through the forest, you've seen them all around Thylea your whole life. They are the hands of Kentamane, also known as the Hundred-Handed. He is a titan that was said to be the husband of Thylea herself, which was also a titan goddess kind of thing. And his hands are strewn about all around Thylea and have never moved to anyone's recollection. So those hands on the map are literally the hands of Kentamane that are said to be of a titan that's long been dormant.
Yeah, it was like you'll literally find his hands pop out of anywhere. Don't know if anyone tried smashing them, but probably someone did. But you mostly find hands everywhere.
People just making stories up about the hands. Did anybody see this?
I mean,
well, it took well some. I think Kyra's been there.
We saw a few arms and hands sticking out of the ground. several days ago, like right near the commencement of our journey.
Yep.
Okay, so I'm sure you guys aren't talking about that. The last of the goatlings dies by Lorius's arrow. Things seem to settle. The satyr does not attack any of you. He looks down at his bloodied and nasty clothes, catches his breath.
No, oh, by the fates, it's not today. Seems like every day something else tries to kill me. If you're here to kill me, just get it over with. Many have tried, none have succeeded yet.
I mean, to be fair, that is because Greased Lightning and I have healed you.
By the way, I'm Greased Lightning.
Yeah, Greased Lightning.
Yes, he is of much fame and rapport.
Yeah,
Greased Lightning is just one of the many vestiges he wears in order to exert his dominance and strength.
But yeah, you can that. Just call me Zark. I kind of prefer that.
That too.
Yep. Why would all these goatlings trying to murder you anyway?
You can ask them, but their crazed look in their eye, they would never answer you.
Oh, they do, but it's mostly cackles for the most part. The first time I've met goatlings. Most chaotic thing you ever seen.
But we weren't asking them, we were asking you. Why did they try to kill you?
Yeah, why were they trying to kill
you? What's going on here? It seems like there's some weird shit going on.
Came here for answers. Answers as to what's trying to kill me.
The goatlings? Those are the things that were trying to kill you?
It's goatlings today, it's something else tomorrow. There's something else behind it. And the gods have been playing a sick joke on me since the day I was born.
How long ago were you born?
I don't know anymore. It's living on the run, trying to just survive, or, you know, some days I try to die.
You try to die?
Yeah, wouldn't you end it all if you could?
No. Pretty morbid.
Weird way to think about it. So, why were they... Have they been attacking you before? Or is this just the first time?
These ones, it was the first time. And their last.
Yeah. They're going to do it very easily. Luckily we showed up at the right time.
Yeah, I appreciate the help.
Yeah, your old friend there told us to visit. So we came at the right time.
Haven't seen you in ages, my friend.
Are you talking to Lorius?
Yeah, Lorius.
Yeah, I ran into these guys and they killed Demetria. She was doing her ritual thing again that you worked so hard to protect the young folks of Astoria, and they went to her dinner and they killed her.
Yeah, I was looking for Demetria to find some answers myself.
Who sent you to seek out Demetria? Because you told me a while ago that she was too powerful.
Well, ever since I started having some visions, I ended up answering the Oracle and she pointed me to the path of Demetria to find the answers.
Yeah, the Oracle tried to kill us too.
Yeah, it's like we've met her. Let's just say we got lucky for the most part. We can tell when she was trying to murder us anyway.
Definitely. Oracle tried to murder you?
Yeah, sent us to our death.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not... Well, it's more like she's... She'll give you an idea where to go. It's not how to do it most of the time.
She says it's like our way to prove ourselves, and she's just like, yeah, it's fine. Just go over there, and then, like, we meet up with freaking gods, and they try and kill us. So, you're not the only one, sir.
Yeah, it sounds like it's all a sick joke from the gods.
You are a sir, right? You're not a sir, ma'am? Ma'am, sir?
I think ma'am. The beard gives it away.
Sir.
Okay. Well, I mean, I've met a bunch of satyrs that are females that
they also have some weird things
going on.
Some have beards, too. So, what exactly... What's with all the skulls, anyway? It's like pointing to that staff he has.
Eh, just to scare people away.
There's more ways. Probably need more skulls, then.
Yeah. So,
Speaking of more skulls, do you want any of these skulls that are kind of laying around down here to add to your staff?
No.
Do you have specific skulls you're looking for?
No, the set's complete.
Oh, alright.
Okay, so how long have you lived in this place?
I don't actually live here. Here is where, after I found the dead corpse of Demetria, here's where it's supposed to be the gathering of the Faerun energy that it, I was trying to seek knowledge. That's when I was interrupted by this group of goats and other things.
They didn't seem to want you to find the answer. What were you looking for anyway? Like, what kind of question were you going to ask it?
Who is going to kill me?
Well, we know that. I mean, I guess for certain it's not these things anymore. That's good. I think you have to be more specific with that question. A lot of things can kill you.
Yeah, but there's something greater.
You talking about?
You still think you're going to find the answer here?
I don't know. Need to look around.
Well, look around. If you can't find the answer, you might as well come with us and try to figure it out on the way.
Yeah, so...
I'll go exactly... sit on a bench over here.
Bench, okay.
So you're lazy. Got it.
Okay, so were these things having any weapons in the middle?
Oh, they have daggers. They have lots of knives.
Okay, lots of knives. Trust me.
We just need a sword for him, but we can't give him the knives. It's like too much. It's like not enough knives. He has enough knives.
So you all see the satyr take a seat at the bench, and you see him close his eyes. Grab this pendant on his necklace, starts to gently rock back and forth, mumbling. You catch that the language is Sylvan in nature. Does anyone speak Sylvan?
Let's see.
I'm checking, but I'm pretty sure I do.
Okay.
I'm sure I don't.
Solano Deo, you probably do.
Where am I? Oh, okay. Wait. Don't elves speak Sylvan?
I do. I speak Celestial, Common, Giant, and Sylvan.
Okay.
I do not.
Wait, what do elves... I just know Elvish. Yeah, not Sylvan.
So you hear a sort of a chant, a ritual chant... a prayer, if you will, in Sylvan. And this satyr is speaking to the gods, speaking to the titans, speaking to the fates, asking for guidance, asking for answers, asking why his whole life he's been targeted by fey creatures, targeted and made fun of, the butt of jokes his whole life. You could hear the anguish in his voice as he seeks direction. And to your surprise, to all of your surprise, you see the light in the bush glow in his chant. As he hits these certain rhythms, it becomes a bit of a poetic dance with the light of the brambles and his own prayer. And before long, both Mike and Solano Deo, or Alistair and Solano Deo, you hear in Sylvan the light of the brambles respond. And the language of Sylvan, the Fey language, you hear, "You, Alistair, are destined to die by the workings of Lutheria. You have more to do in this life, a part to play with the heroes of the Heartlands. Only the fates can tell you more about your destiny, but more importantly, about the true nature of your birth." And the light slowly fades. The brambles turn into a pile of brambles. Alistair, you find your breath returning to its normal rhythm and pace, sweat on your brow as you take this knowledge in.
More riddles, more mystery. It looks like I'll at least find an answer if I go with you wherever you're going.
Shin, do you think this is a safe spot to fall asleep at?
As long as we throw the corpses off the ledge, we're fine.
Or do you have, like, a house nearby? Because Glorious was saying that you had a house nearby.
It's down the way a little bit, but there's no telling what'll be between here and there.
What's a little bit? Like a 10-minute walk or like a 3-hour walk?
It's more than a 120 feet.
Does not answer my question.
This looks as safe a place as any.
Does it? I mean, we almost... I mean, you died like 17 times.
Yeah,
like 3 minutes ago.
Yeah.
But did I?
You look at the blood on you, man. It's hard to get out, man. Need some vinegar for that.
Well, I mean, if you feel safe here, I don't trust you, but I guess we can just camp here. You guys all want to set up camp here?
If we have to, we can.
He doesn't seem very confident about getting to his house. So.
Yeah, if we have to make a camp, we can.
Let's do it. We're all almost dead.
You're not wrong.
I've got nothing to help us. I've I've used everything that I can.
Yep, we just got them.
Yep.
And I barely have... I'm just tired. Only 2 hit points are left, so I need to rest.
You should sit down on a bench.
I don't think that works for all of us, sir.
I'm gonna sit over here on this bench.
I just need to take like a quick 8-hour nap.
So you guys set up for camp. Kyrah mentions how beautiful it is to get away from the city of Mytros. And
I agree, Kyrah.
Points to the constellations in the sky.
Oh, here we go again.
Yeah, this is what we do. We look at constellations. We have to guess them.
Let me bring Mike onto the map real quick.
Yep, he's the new star. Put him in there.
Yeah. So, you look at the night sky. Oops, Vulcan's not with you. Kyrah points out several important stars and constellations, and she says, you know, since that vision had guided you to speak to the fates, perhaps we should discuss the fates.
At least the stars are different. At least they're blinking now.
Let me see if I can find the constellations. Okay. Okay. The fates. Is in the constellation of the bard. Hey, I'm a bard, says Kyrah. Which is...
I believe you. You just want to talk about yourself.
Yeah. Okay. The bard would be this star here, and the 4 stars kind of around it. The 2 to the right representing the instrument, and the 2 to the left representing the bard. So here's how the story goes, Kyrah says. And she actually plays a little tune with it. She says, during the first war, Pelennia...
I slightly vomit.
What's that?
I slightly vomit.
Okay.
During the first war, Pelennia, a famous bard, was captured by Lutheria, the goddess of dreams and death. Terrified as to her fate, Pelennia sang songs of dark humor that made light of the first war's atrocities, won Lutheria over, and so won her freedom. But as she departed, Pelennia grew overbold and tried to steal Lutheria's treasures. She was captured again and taken to the island of Oathbreakers. There, Lutheria made her an offer. If Pelennia could make her laugh with one last song, then all would be forgiven. Before Pelennia could take up her lute, Lutheria reached out with her claws and ripped out the bard's tongue, forever silencing her beautiful voice. The 5 stars in the constellation of the bard remind us of Pelennia's tale. The 2 brightest are the singer herself. The next 2 symbolize her lute. The small flickering star between them all is her severed tongue. So...
My stars stop blinking. I have no idea which ones you're pointing at.
Oh, yeah, that's okay.
It's a tongue. Is that the tongue?
No, this is the tongue, this is the bard, and this is her lute. Guys. Kyrah says, you know, it's about another day's travel to get to the Dead Falls. And I have to tell you guys, I'm a little nervous. There's things that you should know before we go to the Ultros.
What exactly do we need to know?
Well, that's...
Why are you going to the Dead Falls?
Oh, yes, perhaps you all should inform our new friend here why we are going to the Dead Falls.
Because we were gifted a map of lost famous ship. I don't really know, other than that.
We're just apparently asked to do something, so we're just investigating that to find any more clues or discover anything.
I'm sorry, what?
Looking for shit.
Looking for a ship.
It's not just any ship. I mean, that's kind of what I wanted to talk to you guys about. It's the legendary Ultros.
Right. The legendary ship.
Did I ever tell you why it was legendary?
No, Kyrah, you haven't. Otherwise, we would have an idea of why we're going here.
Well, the truth is you will never be able to get very far in any other ship. Lord Sidon is so powerful that he can waylay any ship that goes out to sea, except for the Ultros.
Why is that?
I'm not sure, but it has survived the storms of Sidon.
Oh, that is interesting.
And it's the only one that we know that has survived the storms of Sidon.
Yeah, it would be interesting to have a ship that can actually use the sea, go anywhere in the sea without getting swept aside.
Right, and if you are to face Lord Sidon, he tends to reside in the Tower of Praxis, and that is in the Cerulean Gulf, which he can essentially create a storm powerful enough to waylay any ship that is trying to head in his direction. But if you have the Ultros, then you can meet him at his doorstep if you wish. But
meet him we shall.
That's not what I really needed to talk to you about.
So you are trying to kill yourselves.
Wait, what?
It may seem like suicide to face Lord Sidon, but as you're aware, Alistair, the Oath of Peace is ending, and it's ending soon. And if we do nothing, then Lord Sidon and his sister wife Lutheria will wreak havoc, especially on the settler races. And I don't know how you feel about them, but I've grown a bit accustomed. But yes, I suppose you have to be a bit mad to consider facing Titans.
Yes. So, mostly, it's more curious about that ship. See if it's still intact, and for the most part.
Yes.
Also, weren't you telling us about a tongue being cut out? Wouldn't that be your tongue?
No, I'm not Polenia. Polenia was a bard.
Oh,
and
Polenia.
Yeah.
Different bard.
Nope.
I heard bard, I thought you.
Oh, wishful thinking, there's our...
You make the most lovely music, so I just wanted to, trust me, I was really hoping your tongue was cut out. I mean, it's really hoping it wasn't about you. That's what I say.
Well, I do have a tale. Well...
No, you don't. I've got a tail.
Ew.
Inspiration.
Another one.
Yeah, you got to use them to use them. So you see kind of a rare serious tone come over Kyrah's face. And she says, "Do you recall in all of our journeys together, or Alistair, do you recall from what you know of Thylea's history, who the captain of the legendary Ultros was?"
I don't think I know that one.
Okay. Does anyone know the name Esther Arkalander?
Got that guy?
What have they got? What side on Slime Boy?
Well, he was a dragon lord who was a great, great warrior. You know, let's do it differently. Kyrah reaches into a satchel and pulls out a small mirror. She says, "This is a little unorthodox, but I believe it's the best way to show you the man, the many facets of the man that is Esther Arkalander, the Dragonlord who captained the famous legendary Ultros." And she holds out the mirror. Does anyone take it?
I will.
Okay. So, it is a mirror of the past, she tells you. She asks you to hold the mirror when you're ready, but having all the rest of you gathering around. She also holds out a pair of sending stones. And she says to stare into the mirror while thinking about the stones. And what's going to happen, she warns you, it's going to provide useful information on how the first war began. So, if Zark, you hold the mirror while the remaining of you gather around and stare into the mirror.
Yep.
And you concentrate on the stones while looking into the mirror. Are you ready?
Oh. Alright. Here we go! Sorry. Hold the mirror up position. And I stare into the mirror.
Touch some stones.
And I'm grabbing my stones.
All you see in the mirror is the reflection of you and your traveling companions. It takes quite a few seconds before you begin to realize that the odors surrounding you have begun to fade away and are slowly being replaced by the smell of leather tents, campfires burning, and an overwhelming scent of smoldering metal. As the reflection begins to grow fuzzy, you notice that the sound of footsteps on lush grass surrounds you with joyful hollering to match, but a very deep and raspy set of breaths demands your attention more than anything. Your reflection in the mirror is now nothing but a blur with a background of green and red, but a large area of gold in the center of your vision. Just as you begin to realize that the smell of smoldering metal seems to come and go with the sound of heavy breathing, your vision begins to sharpen and the golden object in front of you comes into focus as a beautifully fearsome copper dragon with bright green glowing eyes. It greets you with a smile and an outstretched open claw containing a familiar looking stone.
Don't look like
ascending stone.
So one of the stones we're grabbing.
Mm-hmm. The dragon looks at you and says, "Greetings. I'm Arcarania."
You can see us?
You all look at your bodies, and you are those characters that you created, and that's where we're going to start next session. So,
yes! Prequel episode!
Mike's going to be all confused. Like, I don't even have grasp of my character now, and you're sending me back 500 years ago?
damn it. No.
I am so stout!
So you
touch
are
something from the gods.
Yeah, let's see.
Okay, I gotta kill all the Minotaurs. Got it. And as like Zark slowly fades out of existence.
So I'll give you a little bit of info that the scene that you're in, you're in a war camp, midday, in the middle of a hill covered in grassland. The mirror is gone from your hand, Zark, and this dragon, Arcarania, drops a stone into her hand and says to take care of it, and that that they want it back when your mission is complete. But we will go into the mission and the rest of the scene. Let's talk about characters real quick. So you guys have your character sheets for that situation, I believe.
Yep. I'm supposed to give them a name. I never did.
Yeah, I don't think you ever did, but you're welcome to change their name. And Alistair, I think you said you're cool with going with Bingo?
Yeah, a goblin cleric?
Yeah, unless you want to make something in D&D Beyond, and you know, I could still import all the stats from D&D Beyond pretty easily. But you could also be a goblin cleric, because that's what Ashaya made.
That sounds good with me.
All right. So, yeah, the...
Like, I just made a character. We're not using it. I'm not making another freaking character.
This is a one-shot. Most things will probably be broken. You know, things... I'm going to have to reread it just to make sure I can make sense of it. But... But yes, it will hold
to like everything that's not broken.
It's still connected to the world at large. It is a prequel episode. It is very much tied into what's coming up in terms of Esther Arcalander. And you essentially are going to be playing characters that were alive and fighting in the first war.
Awesome.
I kind of want to see if there's like... If it's like this thing of brass, like I just want to see like implications of these characters have been there, you know. Or it's like you just see like Easter eggs of our characters, you know.
Well, your characters probably weren't alive then.
Yeah, but it's like I just imagine he's all rusted and he's all in clockwork because he can't find anything, considering it's all it's just basically all bronze here.
Yeah. So next session will be probably taken up with the whole one shot, or a majority of the session will be. And then from there, we'll move into the Deadfalls and figure out what kind of mess we can get into from there. Let's talk about schedule. So I know, Solano Deo, you wanted to switch to Thursdays because of your class, but it sounds like you get out of class pretty late. Do you want to try to figure out if there's a better time?
What I'm thinking now is that because this is like an extra thing for my French major, and I'm not going to be on until 6:30 now, and also not